I would describe Thrive as a place where kids from underrepresented groups come together to build community and really get to know how independent schools work.
Having Thrive be a community of people that were also people of color, that was really nice to see myself be represented.
I've kind of come from feeling kind of awkward about being an outsider and not necessarily being understood by other people about how my race or my socioeconomic status affects who I am and how I am in the school community. Thrive is really a space that has empowered me and taught me to celebrate the differences.
I feel good because it's easier for me to make friends.
Part of the work that we're trying to think about is what does it mean to support positive identity development at such a young age, and how can we be there so that even if students, maybe there are things that they won't come to really be able to articulate for years, but as they're first having those foundational experiences, do they feel represented? Do they feel seen and heard? Do they feel like they have someone who understands them as a whole person? One of the projects that we're doing in Lower School Thrive right now is based on a book. It's called If You Come to Earth. And the author kind of takes the perspective of if an alien were looking at or visiting Earth, what would they need to know? And it talks a lot about diversity. And what we're doing is creating our own version of If You Come to Nueva. What would sort of an outsider need to know about what it means to be a Nueva student?
We're also really excited to begin thinking about a Thrive orientation, which is kind of an onboarding space for families and students that we're bringing down to Nueva to introduce them to what Nueva is and what it might look like and feel like to be a student and a family at Nueva. So that's going to be partnering with both our teachers and current Thrive students on that onboarding and welcoming orientation over the summer.